Buoyage is the general term that we use to cover markers that indicate the edges of safe water in channels, open seas and danger areas. There are a number of special buoys to mark special purpose areas, such as swimming areas, military practice areas and areas reserved for a particular activity, such as jet skis. We will talk about the different groups of buoys later in the video. There are a number of buoys that are used to show us where the safe water is and where the dangers are. A good mariner will immediately recognise a buoy and know what action to take to keep the vessel in safe water. In the old days, there was a number of buoy systems used in different parts of the world, and after a few notorious sinkings in the 70s, it was decided to create a worldwide system of buoy. Unfortunately, due to the large number of buoys already in existence, it was not possible to have all countries using the same colour buoys to mark the port and the starboard side of channels. And so two flavours of one system came into being. The system is called the International Association of Lighthouse Authorities, IALA, and with Part B covering the Americas and some parts of Asia, where their port and markers are green, whilst the rest of the world maintains a red buoy to port marker system, which is known as IALA. The two regions of the world are shown in the map here. The parts of the world shaded green have their port and markers green, and the rest of the world has red markers on the port hand side of the channels. And this is when proceeding in towards the port or a river. Two buoys that are easily remembered if you group them together is the safe water buoy and the danger buoy. The safe water buoy is red and white, and you can think of that like a stick of candy or something like that. And it's got on the top a red ball, and we like to think of that as being a red apple. So when you've been out at sea and you're looking to get into port and do some shopping and get some nice fresh vegetables or from some fresh fruit, then this is the one to get. So you can think of it as a red cherry or a red apple on top of the buoy. And this is your welcome into the port, and quite often these are used to show where the start of the channel is. At night time, the safe water buoy flashes either an isophase light or a long flash light. However, the danger buoy is black and red. Black and red, you can think of this as Dennis the Menace, the old cartoon character, or you can think of a red-backed spider, which is obviously quite dangerous. So this is what we call an isolated danger. You don't want to go anywhere near the isolated danger. It's marking a little bit of wreckage, an old ruin, or some isolated rock. Whatever it is, you don't want to go there. And this is marked on the top with two black balls. So you think of the difference between the two buoys is the safe water is a nice red cherry, and on the top is two black balls. You want to stay away from the two black balls. And at night time, it's flashing two white lights. And the white lights, if you think of two flashes together, it's like saying, stay away. Stay away. So that's the two buoys, the safe water buoy and the danger buoy. The next two buoys that we have are port hand markers and starboard hand markers, and these mark the edge of the channels. Under the IALA system, the port buoys are red colour and the starboard buoys are green colour. Both of them have a top mark, and the port top mark is a can shape, so you can think of a can of tomato soup, and the starboard buoy is a green shape, so you can think of a Christmas tree shape. So those two top marks give you an idea when the sun is a little bit low, or the what we call the colour temperature isn't high. You can't quite make out what colour the buoy is by looking at the top mark. However, you can work out whether it's a port or a starboard buoy. Remember, under IALA system in the US and in parts of Asia, the actual shape is the same, but the colours are different. At night time, we can identify the red port hand buoy because it flashes a red light, and we can identify the green starboard hand buoy because it flashes a green light. There are another set of buoys. We call these special buoys, and they mark a special area. Their top mark is an X, and you can think of this as extra special, and this is marking something like a military firing practice area, a swimming area, a jet ski area, could be a construction area, outfall for sewage pipes. It could be anything that's not covered by the other buoys. Always yellow. The light that they flash is always yellow. Their shape can be any shape, but it must be painted yellow. Cardinal buoys, these actually tell us which direction to go with respect to the compass. For example, a north buoy will say we have to go north. We don't need to know why we can't go south. The buoy tells us we have to go north. The top mark actually tells us which direction the buoy is. For example, if it looks like two arrows pointing up, that's north. Two arrows pointing down is south. Arrows pointing towards the middle, so it looks like a wine glass, would be west. And with the two bases together, it could look like an egg, so we think of east. They actually mark where we should go rather than where the danger is. The lights at night flash white, and you can think of a clock whereby the east buoy is 3 o'clock, the south buoy is 6 o'clock, and the west buoy is 9 o'clock. For the 12 o'clock position, we just say it keeps flashing all the time. We don't need to count to 12. Now let's look at each buoy individually. The north cardinal buoy has arrows pointing up. Both arrows are pointing up. You could say like up on a chart is north on a chart. Also the colour of the buoy being black and yellow, the black part of the buoy is where the arrows point. So if the arrows point up, then the top of the buoy, that is the one that's black. And at night time, it just keeps flashing all the time. The east cardinal has the bases of the arrows together, so the actual arrows point to the very top and to the very bottom. And you'll see the colours are the same. Black is to the very top and also to the very bottom, and the rest of it is yellow. And the light is flashing three times, because this buoy, if you look on a watch, this buoy is in the 3 o'clock position. East is the 3 o'clock position, so it flashes three times. A south cardinal, both arrows point down. If you like on a map or a chart, down is where the south is, and on the buoy itself, the black part is the down or is the lower part. And the light, being a 6 o'clock on the clock face, so it's going to flash six times. However, as a special identifier, so we don't get confused with 9 or 3, actually at the end of the 6th flash, there's going to be a long flash. You can think of this as being in a restaurant. You're not sure if you're on table 6 or table 9. The 6 has got a long line underneath it, and so the light is also flashing. 6 flashes, and then a long line or a long flash after that. The west cardinal. The two arrows point towards the middle, and you can think of this as looking like a waistline figure or a wine glass. The two arrows are pointing towards the middle, so the part of the buoy that's black is in the middle. And at night time, think of it as being the west is on a compass, is in the 9 o'clock position, so it's flashing nine times. A fairly new buoy is the emergency wreck marker buoy, and this is coloured blue and yellow, and it's got like a cross on the top mark. You can think of this buoy as when a ship suddenly sinks, a helicopter flies out and drops this marker buoy, this emergency wreck marker buoy, in that area. Its light is flashing blue and yellow. You won't find it on the chart, because once they've actually established where the wreck is or cleared the wreck, then they'll replace this with a normal cardinal buoy, or if the wreck has been removed and it's no danger to navigation, then there'll be no need for any kind of marker buoy at all. So that's the emergency wreck marker buoy. It's just a temporary buoy that's there until they sort out the wreck.